Who am I? You sure you want to know? The story of my life is not for the faint of heart. If somebody said it was a happy little tale, if somebody told you I was just your average, ordinary guy, not a care in the world, somebody lied.
How was school today?
It's okay. This crazy car parked outside.
Tony, it's about time we met. You've been getting my emails, right?
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
Parker, now I remember you. You're Connor's student. He tells me you're brilliant. He also tells me you're lazy.
Trying to do better.
Remember, it is a privilege to be here. We are guests of Columbia University Science Department, so behave accordingly. Let's not have a repeat of our trip to the planetarium. Come on, people, let's stay together, proceed up the steps, and into the building.
What's your name?
Peter Parker.
Okay. Great.
Weird.
I'm sticking. And I'm climbing. But human beings can't do all this. We can't.
Something's bothering him. Maybe he's too embarrassed to tell me what it is. Maybe I'm too embarrassed to ask him anything. I don't know. I just don't know anymore.
Hey, well. Going to the downtown library. I'll see you later.
Oh, yeah, wait, Pete. I'll drive you there, buddy.
Oh, no, I'll take the train.
No. I need the exercise. Go on. Go.
Well, kiddo, we're here.
Uncle Ben, if you could do something and do it better than anyone else, then it wouldn't be wrong to, you know, cash in on your talents, right?
Well, son, that would depend on what talents we're talking about. Listen.
Pete, look, you're changing. I know. I went through exactly the same thing at your age.
No, not exactly.
Peter, these are the years when a man changes into the man he's going to become the rest of his life.
Just because you can't do something doesn't mean you should. With great power, there must also come great responsibility.
You're a lot like your father. You really are, Peter, and that's a good thing. But your father lived by a philosophy, a principle, really. He believed that if you could do good things for other people, you had a moral obligation to do those things. That's what's at stake here. Not choice, responsibility.
With great power comes great responsibility.
That's nice. That's great. It's all well and good, so where is he?
What?
Where is he? Where's my dad? He didn't think it was his responsibility to be here to tell me this himself.
Oh, come on. How dare you?
How dare I? How dare you?
Quit worrying about me, okay? Something's different. I'll figure it out. Stop lecturing me, please.
I don't mean to lecture, and I don't mean to preach. And I know I'm not your father.
Then stop pretending to be.
Right. I'll pick you up here at 10.
Peter, come back here, please. Peter! $50. The ad said $3,000.
We'll check it again, Webhead. It said $3,000 for 3 minutes, and you pinned them in two. For that, I give you $100, and you're lucky to get that.
But that's not fair.
Fair's not my problem.
I need that money.
I missed the part where that's my problem. Hey, what the hell?
Put the money in the bag.
You're gonna pay? You're holding up my line.
I don't have 2 cents.
You can't afford your milk. Just step aside. But Daddy didn't give you enough milk money today?
It's 2 cents. We're talking about 2 cents.
Just step aside, kid. Really?
Hey! That's my money! Kid, stop!
Hey! He stole the game!
Stop that guy!
He's got my money!
Thanks.
Whoa. Out of my way, man!
Not my problem. What the hell's the matter with you? You let him go!
Cut him off in the lobby and call a cop!
You could have taken that guy apart. Now he's gonna get away with my money.
I missed the part where that's my problem.
Not my problem.
Never doubted the man you'd grow into. How you were meant for great things. You won't disappoint him.
I can't help thinking about the last thing I said to him. He tried to tell me something important, and I threw it in his face.
Gonna fix you something?
No, thanks.
People like Uncle Ben can never be replaced. The things they stood for can be carried on through our beliefs and through our work.
He told me that with great power
comes great responsibility.
I think I truly understood what he meant until that night. But in order to live up to that motto, I need to become something more than a celebrity. A beacon of hope. I need to become a hero. Since being bitten by that spider at Oscorp, I've been given a gift of great power. They're not to be taken lightly.
Oh.
Know that although I've been called many things, a menace, amazing, spectacular, sensational, you know me best as Spider-Man.
All right, let's get to work.
Some true stories to tell.
Wake up, little spider. Wake up. You're an amazing creature, Spider-Man. You and I are not so different.
I'm not like you. You're a murderer.
Well, to each his own. I chose my path, you chose the way of the hero. And they found you amusing for a while. The people of this city.
They love me.
But the one thing they love more than a hero is to see a hero fail, fall, die trying. In spite of everything you've done for them, eventually they will hate you. Why bother?
Because it's right.
Here's the real truth. There are 8 million people in this city, and those teeming masses exist for the sole purpose of lifting the few exceptional people onto their shoulders. You, me, we're exceptional.
Your weakness, Peter, is morality.
That pathetic sickness.
It's choking you. Can't you feel it?
Hey, it's gonna be okay. This is gonna be all right.
You don't give people hope. You take it away.
I'm responsible. What happened to Uncle Ben?
I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry I should have shot
you. I just really miss him. The thief was running towards me. I could have stopped him, but I wanted revenge. Uncle Ben was killed that night for being the only one who did the right thing. Listen, about my last visit.
Pish posh, we needn't talk about it. It's water over the dam or under the bridge or wherever you like it, but... But you made a brave move in telling me the truth, and I'm proud of you. And I thank you, and I love you, Peter, so very, very much.
Put the pants in the box, Mrs. Parker.
Thank you, Henry.
Hi, Peter.
Hey, Henry. You're getting tall.
You'll never guess who he wants to be. Spider-Man.
Why?
Well, he knows a hero when he sees one. Too few characters out there
flying around like that, saving old girls like me. And Lord knows, kids like Henry need a hero. Courageous, self-sacrificing people, setting examples for all of us. Everybody loves a hero. People line up for them, cheer them, scream their names, and years later they'll tell how they stood in the rain for hours just to get a glimpse of the one who taught him to hold on a second longer. I believe there's a hero in all of us that keeps us honest, gives us strength, makes us noble, and finally allows us to die with pride, even though sometimes we have to be steady and give up the thing we want the most. Even our dreams.
You're not Iron Man. You're never gonna be Iron Man. Nobody could live up to Tony. Not even Tony. Tony was my best friend. And he was a mess. He second-guessed everything he did. He was all over the place. The one thing that he did that he didn't second-guess was picking you. I don't think Tony would have done what he did if he didn't know that you were going to be here after he was gone.
That's not a hug. I'm just grabbing the door for you. We're not there yet.
And your friends are in trouble. You're all alone. Your tech is missing. What are you going to do about it?
I'll kick his ass.
Yeah, open that. Okay, no.
What?
Nothing. You take care of the suit, I'll take care of the music.
Easy to fool people when they're already fooling themselves.
Become someone your own size, Rhino.
There is no one by size.
Fool. No prey escapes Craven.
I'll kill you, big. I'll kill you dead.
You ugly as fuck.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you step in the wet.
Out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they carry up us?
Serving up a look.
Pizza.
Dancing in a drop. Hello to the big step, but never
do what you think is best, Doc.
I hate it when they team up. Just need to catch my breath.
Try and understand how I feel, Peter.
Peter, what do you need to say to me? What's the one thing?
Take you somewhere, you know I care.
I love you.
But it's so cold and I don't know where.
Your mom.
I brought you daffodils on a pretty string.
Oh, lovely.
But they were beautiful.
They were nice.
You know, they're beautiful.
MJ, I'm
Spiderman.
And I wanna kiss you, make you feel alright.
My marriage got tested. My wife and I stood up.
She wanted kids and it scared me.
I have to go to England, Peter. It's important to me. I mean, I don't know. Maybe we're on different paths right now.
No offense, but you're wrong. You're wrong about us being on different paths. We're not on different paths. You're my path. And you're always going to be my path.
England. Both of us. I'm following you now. I'm just gonna follow you everywhere. I'm just gonna follow you the rest of my life.
Peter, what's going on?
I know this isn't real.
Do you though?
Oh, MJ! Oh, MJ!
You're gonna forget who I am. Okay, wait, what are you talking about?
It's okay. I'm gonna come and find you.
Stay with me.
I was lucky with Peter Parker when I came up with that character because he's probably more like a regular person, a normal person, than any other character. And I try to make him that way because I guess until Peter Parker, no superhero or no superhero's alter ego had ever had to worry about making a living, getting along well with girls, being popular.
That's
or have all the problems that I tried to heap as many problems as I could on poor Peter because I feel most people, even people who seem to be happy, have problems and they have worries. For example, I had not read any of the superheroes who very often felt they wished they could quit being a superhero because it's not a normal life and he's miserable and maybe he's not doing the right thing. I made him a guy who is very introspective. He questions, why am I doing this?
It's easy to feel hopeful on a beautiful day like today. But there will be dark days ahead of us too. There will be days where you feel all alone. And that's when hope is needed most. No matter how buried it gets, or how lost you feel, you must promise me that you will hold on to hope. Keep it alive. We have to be greater than what we suffer. My wish for you is to become hope. People need that. And even if we fail, what better way is there to live? As we look around here today, at all of the people who helped make us who we are, I know it feels like we're saying goodbye, but we will carry a piece of each other into everything that we do next to remind us of who we are and of who we're meant to be.
Whatever life holds in store for me, I will never forget these words. With great power comes great responsibility. This is my gift, my curse. Who am I? I'm Spider-Man.